Edward Casey lived in the late 1800s and the 1900s. He was probably one of the most documented psychics to ever live. Let me introduce you to the man with some unusual events in his life. Then join our journey as we discuss his recorded beliefs on future prophecy, reincarnation, karma, past lives, and dreams. Welcome to Ladder Cat Production, the place for health, science, and fun. Edgar Casey was an American clairvoyant who claimed to channel a collective consciousness source to answer questions about health and healing, reincarnation, dreams, the afterlife, past life, nutrition, Atlantis, and future events while in a self-induced sleep state. Casey said his subconscious mind would explore the dream realm where all subconscious minds are timelessly connected. He was known as the Sleeping Prophet and the father of holistic medicine and the most documented psychic of the 20th century. Edward Casey was born on March 18, 1877, just south of Hopkinsville, Kentucky. He was one of six children of farmer parents. As a child, he played with the little folk and saw his deceased grandfather. He said they were incorporeal because one could see through them. When he was a boy of 10, he was taken to church and from then read the Bible. In May 1889, while reading the Bible in his hut in the woods, he saw a woman with wings who asked him what he wanted above all. He was scared, but said he would like to be able to help others, especially sick children. He decided he'd become a missionary. The next night, his father received a complaint from Edgar's teacher, and his father ruthlessly tested him for spelling, eventually knocking him out of his chair with exasperation. At that point, Edgar began to hear the voice of the woman with wings. She told him if he could sleep a little, they would help him. He slept with his head on the spelling book. When his father entered the room and woke him, Edgar knew all the answers. In fact, he could repeat anything in the book. His father thought he must have known the answers the whole time and was just fooling him before. The father knocked him out of his chair again for fooling him previously. Eventually, Casey used all his school books that way. By 1892, the teacher regarded Casey as his best student. Casey told the teacher that in his mind, he saw pictures of the pages in the books. Shortly after this, Edgar exhibited an ability to diagnose in his sleep. He was struck on the base of the spine by a ball in a school game and started acting strangely and was put to bed. He went to bed and diagnosed his own cure, which his family prepared and which cured him as he slept. Casey's education stopped in the 9th grade because his family couldn't afford for him to continue, which was sufficient then for working class children. Throughout his life, Casey was drawn to the church as a member of the Disciples of Christ. He read the Bible yearly, taught at Sunday school, and recruited missionaries. He said he could see auras around people, spoke to angels, and heard voices of departed relatives. Casey's wife, Gertrude, became fatally ill with tuberculosis, and in a sleep state, he diagnosed a cure for her after the doctors had given up and cured her. In 1912, Casey, whose everyday conscious mind was not aware of what he said in his readings, had a secretary record them and asked for voluntary donations so he could practice full-time giving readings. He was bombarded with selfish men wanting to make money off his clairvoyance. A few he gave into and did no better than chance would dictate, and make him distraught and dissatisfied until he finally decided to use his gift only to help the distressed and sick. Casey predicted that man will live longer by overcoming effects of age and usage. He predicted a self-fueling perpetual motion machine, conflict in the Persian Gulf, three halls of records from Atlantis will be discovered. Here are some interesting teachings learned from Edgar Cayce. Reincarnation. Each of us goes through a series of lifetimes for the purpose of spiritual growth and soul development. He said our past actions affect our present conditions and what opportunities and challenges we face because of it. It's a karmic effect where we're given a chance to correct a past wrong. Karma means work, deed, or act, and has been interpreted to mean cause and effect. The idea of karma as a soul memory, a pool of information that the subconscious mind draws upon and can utilize in the present. For example, an individual can meet someone and instantly like or dislike someone for no apparent reason. Cayce's readings indicated that there really isn't karma between people, but with oneself. It's an interesting dynamic that we often meet ourselves through our relationships with others. With free will, we can turn the challenges life presents to us into stepping stones for growth or obstacles and stumbling blocks. Either way, we reap what we sow. The good news is our talents and skills are never lost. If you develop an ability in one life, you will still have it available to draw upon in the next. Each lifetime fulfills a purpose. When we die, the next life doesn't occur immediately, for our soul is given a chance to take stock of all it has come to know. Then we decide for ourselves what lessons we need to learn next. We often return to people we have known before, referred to as a soul group. We can be born male or female in any lifetime, and the choice of sex is often made with the purpose of the lifetime in mind. We select surroundings, parents, family location, time period, etc., that will best allow us to learn those lessons we need to learn for completeness. The way we respond to any given situation determines the next experience to be called into action. Dreams. During the dreaming state of sleep, we experience the different levels of consciousness and receive input from the different realms of the spirit world. Through dreaming, we have special access to our spirit within. There is not a question we can ask which cannot be answered from the depths of our inner consciousness when the proper attunement is made. A dream may be of a physical, mental, or spiritual nature and may deal with all manner of psychic manifestations. These include telepathy, clairvoyance, prophetic visions, out-of-body traveling, remembrance of past lives, communication with beings in other realms, including deceased friends and relatives, spirit guides, angels, Christ, and even the voice of God. Dreams can also give invaluable information on the status of the body. All subconscious minds are in contact with one another. On the astral level of existence, the subconscious mind replaces the conscious mind of the soul, and the superconscious replaces the subconscious. The spiritual realm can foresee the future. We have offered a lot of information to ponder on. Please watch, like, comment, and subscribe to our channel. See you next time!